I see an opportunity for a pretty insane surround here, actually. So I want to spearhead. That's a pink army. Really want them to spearhead to here and just trap all of these troops in here. Best way to do that is just squeeze the bubble now, though. There we go, taking that. Cool. Actually, right now, this surround is more important. Let's delete that offensive line and just have them spearhead that. Do it. Same with you guys. The amount of troops in here, yeah, I can't afford to let this get away from us. Spearhead that. From, not from there, but from there. Do it! Boom. Where's this army? Pink army, not quite at Italy yet. That's fine. Ah, oh, there's so many troops in this port. Yeah, you're not going to be taken out anytime soon. They're trapped in there, but they're being irritating. Oh, we got a bit of landing craft. Let's get advanced landing craft. Make sure our naval invasion's ready to go by the time we want to take the Brits. How big is our navy? Something like 2 battle cruisers now. 21 heavy cruisers. Nice. 2 a year. So since we've got 2 lines of that, yeah, 4 a year. Not bad. Look how many factories we have. Whoa! I bet they're being sabotaged pretty damn fast. Oh yes, they are. Glorious. We need some MPs, but yeah, we don't have the manpower for it right now. So. We will leave it. Until that gets up to at least 50k, I'm not going to be putting any more troops in the field. And we're about to get our spearhead. We're about to get our big surround. Pretty glorious, as long as the Spanish don't screw it up. Which is certainly not a given. We could actually send troops around here like that, couldn't we? We'll let the Spanish take care of their part of the front line, though. It's only fair. It's only fair that we trust them to do their job. Boom. Surrounded! How many troops are in here? They're pretty much entirely French. There are some Brits, though. And some US ones. So I'm happy about that. Right, this army's job is now just to crush this. Crush it. And then the Red Army's job now is just... Well, not the Red Army, but my Red Army. there we go. And also, your offensive line is just take all the rest of France. Isn't it glorious? And boom! Go for it. Where are the pink dudes? Are they on this line? No, they're not. Not quite ready for offensive down into Italy. You know what I'm going to do? This is a pain in my ass. I'm going to send all of the troops to that front line. You heard me, I'm a madman. But yeah, this is a pain in the rear guard right now. So, Soviets can hold that line for now. While we mop up the rest of France and this massive surrounded army. Overrun. The communist tide is sweeping. Oh, once we destroy West Germany, we're going to have a massive Volkhemet name. Right now it's a little stunted thanks to them, but once we remove them, we're going to have Volkhemet in giant letters, just like here. 2 big Volkhemets. It's going to be beautiful. And this army's almost gone. Let's watch their losses jump up. France, 1.8 million. When this is finally gone. It was 1.5 million earlier, so there must be, we've taken out a few hundred thousand. That is for sure. Ooh, They're overrun now. Crush them! Okay, now this entire army no longer has a purpose. The Red Army is going to be fine with dealing with them, so actually, why don't we just replace the Pink Army here? Or just have them both ready to fight. Doesn't really matter. Pink Army, start pushing. Actually, no, stop. Because that's not going very well. Wait till we get the Blue Army to reinforce you. Aha! And now we've got this entire army to take this. Go! Boom! Shakalaka! It's taking an entire army of 24 divisions to deal with this. Oh, enemy have air superiority, do they? Awkward. We'll redeploy some of our aircraft in a minute when we've taken the rest of France. Oh, hello. 14 divisions in there, but they're in a port, so they'll be alright for now. Let's just try and cut off as many as we can. There's a Blue Army. There you are. Cool, 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 cool. Oh, there we go. We've taken that. Cool beans. Right. Now that's dealt with. Get on there. Get ready to take the rest of Italy. Oh, that's a lot of divisions and they don't have a port. We took La Rochelle. Oh, beautiful. They're at 1.8, weren't they? Oh, 1.95. And they're about to be a lot higher. There's a lot of US troops in there, actually. 22 US divisions. Oh, beautiful. And they're now at 2.6. 2.06, I should say. What's the US at? I think it's the US can just lose troops willy-nilly. 1.48, okay. That's fine. You guys, yeah, get assigned onto that one. Keep going, fellas. Almost there. Blue Army hasn't all quite arrived yet. We'll wait for them to travel. Or screw it, just attack now. Go for it! And also, Yellow Army, go. See if you can make your way into Italy. Bordeaux is being a bit of a pain in the arse. We should be able to take Cherbourg relatively easily though. Attack from all sides, how's that do? Still not great. We have superiority, right? Yeah, we do. Hmm. You should be losing. You're being attacked from multiple directions with enemy air support. You are attacking the city, though. Hello! France has capitulated. Glorious. There is a naval invasion, though, which Spain may not be able to deal with. They have troops on site, though. It shouldn't get out of hand. Hopefully. France capitulated a lot later than I thought they would. I would have thought France would have capitulated earlier than that. But maybe their national unity is a little higher now. Their national unity isn't a thing anymore, is it? Well, supporters, yeah, yeah, that's fair enough. They are Free France, actually. They're not... Yeah, they're Free France. They're not France, really. I guess they just stay Free France after World War II? Who knows? Dismantle Maginot. Hello! Don't know why I'd want to dismantle Maginot. It doesn't give me anything apart from reduce... the forts. They might be useful. Region-wide industrial integration, industrial land appropriation. Don't want to do that. But war propaganda, that's always a good idea. We do want to change our trade laws though, so we'll leave it for now. Yeah, crush them. And then we're going to have probably have a whole army just to deal with these guys. Hello, Italy is disappearing. Goodbye, Italy. Okay, I may actually have some spare manpower. Let's train up some more garrison divisions. Oh, we have MPs now, don't we? We didn't actually put MPs in the garrison division. Save. There we go. Boom. And we wanted at least another 30 of these, really. but we can only really train 10. Okay, well, 10's better than nothing. That's for sure. Train 10. That's fine. While we continue to mobilize, we will get more manpower to play with. And also, when we stop losing people, we've lost about 30,000 people in this war so far, so... How many have we lost now? 70k. Yeah, so that's where all our manpower has been going. It's been disappearing into the war. Right, Red Army, now your only job is to take Bordeaux. Go for it. Refurbished cruisers! Research bonuses for all of those light and heavy cruisers. Nice. Transport models, marines and stuff, we're not using them. Cheap bombers, spot artillery, torpedo bombers, maybe. We haven't actually got that many these left to do. Airborne technology, okay, that could be helpful, go for that. Obviously we've already researched all the way down the artillery line, so that's not particularly helpful anymore, but hey, whatever. Okay, they are slowly removing their divisions. Like, we're not winning, but whatever. We're not fighting in northern France anymore, though. So, let's move these aircraft down to... Where's the nearest big airbase? They're all kind of full. We'll do Brittany. Screw it. That's fine. I want you guys over the Alpine region. There we go, air superiority always helps. Crush Bordeaux! And then we're probably going to have to get this army to actually occupy our territory. So we're losing a lot of factories. Not that we're even using our occupied factories right now. It's way too confusing to do that. We should try to sort out this mess first. But yeah, we're going to have to do that to crush resistance and sort of create a bit of an Atlantic Wall situation. So yeah, there we go. We've crushed it. Right. Now I need you garrisoning all the coastal areas and all of this territory, really. There's only 24 divisions worth, but... There we go. It's more important to actually cover the coastal areas for now. 12, 17. That requires 38 divisions. Why does it require so many divisions to garrison the bloody low countries? Okay, whatever. 27 divisions, we don't have that many. 22. Yeah, okay, that'll do for now. Army, garrison that. Looks like they've dealt with the naval invasion. That's cool. Yes, and that, and I don't want to say relax, but train a bit, just to get the troops that aren't quite up to snuff just trained up a bit. We got any veteran troops? Nah, all regulars. That's all right. These guys are surrounded. They have good encryption, though. That's one thing. Okay, we do not need this many troops here either. So, Pink Army, let's delete all of your orders and get you up here garrisoning some stuff as well. Have you garrisoned the Low Countries? Because it requires a stupid amount of divisions to do so, for some reason. There we go. Go do that. And, well, yeah, get out of the war zone and then I'll get you training. Just crush that. And crush that. So there we go. Okay. I'm also certain we even need two armies to do this, but hey. It's quite alright. Actually, let's just delete all their orders because it's getting confusing. Right. And then you guys. Okay. Push down to the end of the boot! And you guys, yeah, no longer be careful. Just be, okay, there we go. Be balanced. And off you go. We got air superiority over this region? We do not. Let's move our aircraft. Move the fighters to there. And get them flying over there. And the close air support to there. Get them flying over there. And now we're contesting the airspace. Glorious. And now we have air superiority. Beautiful! Western Europe is under our sway. We started in March, and now it's May. Not too bad. 2 months. For all of Western Europe. Where are those paratroopers? Are they trained up yet? Oh, not quite. Almost. Almost trained up. And then they'll be ready to launch an invasion of Great Britain. Keep them on the back foot. But let's deal with the Republic of Italy first, so I've got one less thing to actually worry about. How long until our justification on West Germany finishes? 4th of August. Okay, a little while. We've got a little while. But once that's dealt with, Volkhemet won't just be stuffed into this side. We'll have Volkhemet in giant letters. It's all about having your name in big letters, you know? It's very important. Holy crap. We do not need to be importing any steel. Actually, I think we can just cancel it entirely. No, not quite. Okay, we need to import some steel from the Soviets. Oil-wise, we're a lot better off as well, actually. But it's certainly nice to not be completely bankrupted on the basis of oil after declaring war in the US. We can also import more rubber from the Japanese, meaning we don't have to import from Brazil. Actually, we don't have to import from these two. Okay, we do only get 4 from them. Okay, cool! Tungsten! Portugal, you have loads. And boom, shakalaka! Look at that! Unfulfilled import requests. Siam. Siam, what are you doing? Okay. Let's close that. How bad's the resistance? Oh, it's bad. It's bad. But let's not worry too much about it. Let's worry about taking Italy. Not that we really need to put in much effort here. Our generals seem to pretty much have a handle on it. Not gonna lie. Base is in low supply, apparently. Hmm. Oh well, that's alright. Ooh, we can get more of these divisions going. God, why do these divisions soak up so much manpower? Jeez. And the front line is just moving faster than some of our troops can keep up. Yeah, we have too many troops here. Yellow Army, basically, yes, yeah, stop. We're running out of supplies, so you guys go and deal with some of this resistance, which is being such a pain in my arse. Crush resistance. 16. We've got 24 divisions, so. There we go. Garrison the rest of France. This is all my territory, isn't it? So we don't do garrisoning that. Perfect. Off you go, Yellow Army. And yeah, you've lost. Well, actually, a few of these divisions were never actually regulars, especially the mechanized. Most of those troops, we just trained them, and we sent them straight out. But yeah, let's get you training up. And Afghanistan capitulated to the Soviets. That is surprising. Why did Japan get part of Afghanistan? What? Oh, I guess yeah, they're fighting for reorganized China. They're going into India now. Wow. If Japan could capitulate India for us, that would be meaty, to say the least. Be pretty awesome. Let's keep our focus on Italy for now, though. Just this army dealing with it, and they're very well equipped to deal with it. Yeah, I think we're alright. The British aren't even attempting naval invasions. Well, they are in Spain, probably because it's Spain. But not for us. We haven't got any warnings. Could just mean they have really good encryption, but hey. Yeah, I think we're alright. The Pax Americana. It's quite late, actually, for the Pax Americana. But still. Yeah, the naval invasions in Spain don't seem to go too well. The AI doesn't quite seem to understand garrisoning the coast to stop the enemy invading. Not particularly effectively, anyway. But Spain seems to be able to deal with the invasions as soon as they pop up, so I'm not going to worry too much. So I'm not going to volunteer to defend them. Are our armies having any effect on the bloody resistance? No. They are not. How's construction? We're not repairing stuff yet, are we? Birth of New Zealand armor. Yeah, they call this thing a what?
What do they call it? The Bob Semple tank in the New Zealand Defence Force. With almost certainly bulletproof iron plating, it will be quite possibly the biggest obstacle any invader will have to overcome. Oh, that's cute. And holy crap, we have a lot of civilian factories. We get 71 from trade and we own 121. That is ridiculous. We're already repairing stuff. Wow, that's insane. Let's build nuclear reactors. We have maxed out all of our actual Swedish territory. So yeah, let's build nuclear reactors in Germany. What could possibly go wrong with that idea? That ought to be enough, right? Nah. Build nuclear reactors in all of our annexed territory. Like so! And then send it to the top of the priority queue. Well, I say top, just above all of the repair work we have to do. Of which there is a lot. And then send these back up there. There we go. Cool beans. We're alright for trade. We actually have too much oil right now. Nice. But then we're not even using half of our factories, so, you know, we'll sort that out in a minute. Want to finish my conquering before we have to deal with industry and the like. Advanced rubber processing. Oh, we're getting all the Italian territories. Oh, nice. We are going to have to garrison all that, though, which is slightly irritating, but hey. That should... Oh, yes! Look at all the rubber we're getting. We're almost actually self-sufficient on rubber. Sweet. Almost self-sufficient. One more upgrade, and I think we might well be self-sufficient for rubber. All right, I need to buy a bit more oil from Venezuela. Because Romania's struggling to cope with demand. And Venezuela's got loads of oil, so it's quite all right. We're importing too much steel now, because we're capturing resources. I was going to change my trade laws, but now we've captured France, with its bounties of resources. Yeah, we're fine. We're only importing a small amount of steel. Not even a huge, no, pretty huge amount of oil still. But we're almost self-sufficient on rubber, which is nice, because rubber's hard to trade for. Oil, we can trade for with the Soviets. Romania and Venezuela, and we're absolutely fine on. So, yeah. Sweet. Next, we can start working on nuclear reactors. Hell yes. I wonder where the atomic thing pops up. It must be up here, because there's no space over here anymore. We've got stability and war support. Decisions we can make. Hello. Yeah, no. I don't know why dismantle Maginot is an option. I really don't want to. Maybe it's if you just occupy Maginot and you're worried it's going to get taken back. I don't know. Let's delete the offensive line. Have one there. And have one in Sicily. You need to maintain your momentum and not get stuck on the edge of Sicily, actually. So, most of you blokes get on that. As well as you two. Boom. And keep going. There we are. Perfect. Look at that. Glorious.
We own a lot of territory. We might have to take Switzerland and Austria. I thought Austria was in the Allies. No, Austria has no faction. This is a piece of Soviet territory. I don't really like the Soviets owning it, though. Not going to lie. I'm going to ask them for the territory. No, that won't work. Okay, probably because we're occupying a lot of Europe. If we took Switzerland and Austria, that would make it look nicer. You know, you guys know I'm all about the nice borders. That'll finish in August. Let's take Switzerland and Austria. Screw it. 185 days. Austria? We need more political power. Okay. That's fine. We'll start with Switzerland. Just control just all of Western Europe. I am determined to. Evil mastermind. Turkey's capitulated. Oh, that took long enough. Soviets. Oh, God, that's ugly. Ugh. You need to hurry up and take Greece and then sort out all the occupied territory because it's not pretty. Not pretty at all. I wonder if I can bully the Romanians into territory. Okay, it's only that territory they can give me. Give me that. Yeah! Hell yes. You can keep all that crap. I don't need any more of that. I just wanted to be able to surround the bit of Soviet territory so then I can ask for it. Looking arse. But I don't really want to go any further south than that. It'll start looking weird. Yeah. What did we research? Oh, we finished our oil processing. Let's grab this one. Modern oil processing. There we are. That should have alleviated even more of our oil problems. Yeah, it did. We don't really have oil problems anymore, but it's better to be able to, you know, rely on yourself. Order. There we go. You folks are fine with taking Sicily. That's cool. Let's make sure we crush these guys before we give them a chance to dig in. There we go. Beautiful. And attack across. Not good. Let's hope they don't stall us here at Sicily. That's happened so many times before, it's not even funny. Okay, come on, army. Oh, Republic of Italy's capitulated. Okay. Oh, I was worried they wouldn't be able to take that. I have actually got to still take this, but yeah. There we go, just destroy that. Cool beans. Nice. Yeah, okay, it must be just because they're pretty unstable because they kind of got, you know, puppeted. We're going to have to take Corsica and Sardinia, though. They're just going to launch nothing but endless naval invasions out of them. Like they're already doing to Spain, which is very irritating. If we control the Med, that would be useful as well. So, yeah, Africa campaign probably needs to happen. The Soviets have got this territory, so it wouldn't be too difficult to send an Africa campaign and actually take the entrance to the Med entirely. Nice to have this part of Europe, at least, you know, one part of it free from naval invasion. We'll focus on that after we've taken this little swath. I'm hesitant to send troops across here because they have a navy here. I would very much like to just ship troops across and then attack from both sides, but I'm not sure that's possible. Counterattack! Go! We have superiority, right? Yep. I think this might be a pain. Anyway, but now we've sort of sorted that. Let's actually sort out all of our industry. Oh, and also our divisions. In training 13, we wanted 30. Okay, we can do 20. There we are. Almost there. Almost there with our garrison units. Though I think we may need more. We got 20. Oh no, sir. 50. 50 would be enough. So garrison all of France. Oh no, we are definitely going to need more. Ugh, we just don't have the manpower. Irritating. They use so much manpower, these goddamn divisions. Right, let's sort this out. Right, 3 dockyards. We've got 10 extra dockyards. Let's stick them on more destroyers. Because we don't have very good heavy cruisers. There we go. Put them there. Okay, and then factory-wise, what do we not have enough of? Light tanks, surprisingly. Okay. Well, we'll step up the production of light tanks a bit. Like so. Then probably stick another 10 or so on fighters. That can never be a bad idea. We'll need to import some more. Wow, we have a lot of that stuff being stockpiled. Yeah, we could almost... We've almost got more equipment than we have, as I said, people to bloody use that equipment. That's mechanized. Mechanized, we've got plenty of that. Yep, we've got loads. We don't really have a use for the rest of them. Apart from maybe more close air support. That's never a bad idea. Okay. I think this is more important than the ships, though. There we go. Okay, I don't really have use for the rest of those factories, so we'll just import enough stuff to make use of all that. Columbia. There we go. We need some aluminium. We need some more rubber. Ah, we were self-sufficient on rubber. How foolish I was to think we could stay that way. We'll have to have some more synthetic refineries. But that's alright. There we go. Yeah, I'm not gonna use any more of those factories. We've got just so many. We just don't need them. We could convert them to civilian factories. That might be a good idea, actually. Then again, we've got billions of those as well. It takes a while to convert factories, we'll just leave it as it is for now. This is irritating me. Now we have shore bombardment. And they have forts there. Oh, that explains a lot. If we try and ship any troops across, the Navy will get us. Which makes this a very irritating predicament. Huh. Do we risk bringing out our Navy to take on the British Mediterranean fleet? I don't know. As it stands, we're just sort of throwing our troops at a wall. I don't know. We should probably start planning our invasion of the UK, though. Our paratroopers are all done, so let's get working on that.